Let me at the outset express my profound sense of gratitude to your chairman and madam, chairperson, for accepting to release this book on this unique occasion. The title of the book is In Joy and Sorrow. And the title, the cover page contains everything what is contained inside. So please permit me to spend 3 minutes to explain what is it all about. This is my own life. The chapters are my father, my mother, my brothers and sisters, my wife, my daughter, and I. These are all the chapters written in very, very simple language. I brought 50 complimentary copies. I am donating 50 complimentary copies to Vienna, Austria. So that is actually indicated by the chair. So once you reach a very big position, don't forget your family. Your family is primary. Other things are secondary. Your job is secondary. That is actually signified by the lovebirds. And the 3 flowers, sunflowers, are myself, my wife, and my daughter. You have only 1 daughter. You are going to see her very soon. We are going to invite you to Vienna. She is based in Australia now. Her name is Diana Arachi, working for the Australian Institute for Health Innovation, currently working on a Harvard University project for the Ministry of Health there. Then there is a rose flower. This design, this cover page was designed by a modern artist hailing from Thailand. I asked the lady, why did you coin this, why did you put this rose flower? She said, rose is full of thorns. So life is full of thorns, difficulties. So one should learn to enjoy difficulties. To come up in life, you should learn to enjoy difficulties. So despite the thorns, rose always smiles. So that is the meaning of that. That's why she put this rose here. I requested our chairman to give this book, 50 complimentary copies, to students who are below average. That does not necessarily mean that your 50 students are below average. No, I just gave it at random. This year maybe 5 students are below average, next year maybe, I don't know. Because I was a mediocre student. In the school I was really, I don't know how did I pass. I don't know, I really, every year when the headmaster read out the list of students who passed, my name was there, and it was a big surprise every year to me. And then pre-university I got only 3rd class, and there is a very interesting story behind it. When I, in a hall like this, when I was sitting for the exam, chemistry exam, the question paper was given to me, and I was the only cool character in the hall. All my classmates were looking at each other and breaking their head like this, and I was the only cool character. I wrote the way I want to write. After the exam, when we were climbing the steps down in the lobby hall of St. Xavier's Garden, I asked my classmates, why did you people, you know, behave like this? You were not perplexed, looking at each other in a disturbed mood. They said, you didn't know. 80% of the questions are out of syllabus. I didn't know even the syllabus. In order to know 80% of the syllabus are out of syllabus, you should know the syllabus. Then I wanted to apply for BSc zoology. The principal, Father Anthony Sami, said, you are useless, totally useless, you cannot be admitted there. So what you have to do, we will admit you for a refugee subject called economics. He said, I have already admitted 19 refugees there. Go and sit in the hall number 19A in the 2nd floor. This is how I got into economics. I was pushed there. Then for many years I didn't study anything and I was easy going. One day for the exam, Elements of Commerce, I just purchased the Moore Market Bazaar note. At that time, Moore Market Bazaar notes were very, very popular. Just glanced through and I was reading something for 2 hours. Next day when I went for the exam, he said, answer 3 out of 5. I came to the feeling that I could answer all the 5 questions. I had the confidence. Then I wrote, after 1 week when the examiner distributed, the lecturer distributed the marks, I stood first.